Reef Builders. I'm Jake Adams. Welcome back to the Reef Builder Studio. I have some tanks to show off for you. Today we're going to talk about my 100 gallon Nuvo EXT soft coral and turbinary aquarium. So this tank has a lot of flowiness, and that's actually a very interesting challenge to film for you guys because the soft corals are never all opened up at the same time, or almost never. And so welcome back to this little mini series. If you haven't seen it yet, make sure to go back and check out the feature of the 40 gallon LPS aquarium, the 75 gallon Euphilia tank. And now it's time for the 4 foot, 100 gallon soft coral aquarium. This particular aquarium was aquascaped and coraled up in just about a day. I've made some small changes since, but I'm actually very happy with how everything's turned out. One of the few challenges with soft corals is all the colors are tan or green. So I think we're gonna spice it up a little bit with some really, really bright orange zoanthids. But let me give you an overview of how this entire aquarium is put together. As I've mentioned many times before, this is the Innovative Marine 100 gallon EXT aquarium. You can see we've got my standard issue yellow tang and convict tang there to be on algae duties. And it just looks so great next to the 2 footer and a 3 footer over there, all in one common system. Definitely go back and watch the previous videos if you want to see how this is filtered. But these tanks are individually flowed and individually lit. For this aquarium, I've got a pair of Aqua Illumination Hydra 52 HD. So that is a stony coral worth of lighting power that I'm using specifically for soft coral. So this is what I was talking about when I say not all the corals are open at the time. So this the capitulum of this leather coral is open. This is the first used coral here at the studio, and the green polyps are only out just a little bit. So this aquarium was actually aquascaped with used natural rock. There's probably about 50 pounds in here. And just like I did on the 75 gallon tank, I'm using Vortex mounted in the back bottom corner with a big open area, big channel along the back. This is a Vortex MP40, and I've got one on the other side as well. And same idea as with the 75 gallon tank. I want the water flow to basically kind of go down the back, flush out any funk, and then just kind of wash over the reef. And to be honest, those MP40s put out a lot more flow than I remember. So these soft corals have really been in like a washing machine. And you can see that with this long polyp leather. This is a long polyp leather, not a weeping willow leather, but still very, very graceful. The water flow must be turned down quite a bit right now, because usually that thing is just going kind of crazy. I've got it programmed. We've got some green polyp leathers here, Japanese green polyp leather, kind of a branching cinularia cabbage, so a little bit different. Got one horn coral just to have something a little bit different from the soft corals, the true Kenya tree, and some more just really funky exotic leather corals here, all different kinds. I just kind of scooped up a bunch of different devil's hands. This is actually green Kenya tree. Sorry, this is Kenya tree, Anethia, and this is what other people call Kenya tree, but it's a green one. So this is a Lithophyton. And this is also supposedly a Japanese green polyp leather. But as you can see, the polyps on this one aren't green, whereas on this one, they are green. No matter what they're called, they're both very, very beautiful. And up here, we've got what you would call like a Palau green Nephthia, but clearly that soft coral and that soft coral are very, very different. And then we've got the pink Stereonephthia there in the back left corner. And a pipe organ that's actually kind of become hidden as this coral has gotten a lot bigger. So, man, I gotta say, I've really enjoyed this tank. The lights on it are more than bright enough. The MP40s are turned way down. And I just realized I forgot to tell you about my little turbinaria haven. So these are all dendrophyllids. So these are mostly all turbinarias. So we've got the peltata. We've got a large polyp guy that I actually collected myself. bifrons that I fragged a long time ago, and we have a couple random pieces of hero coral, Turbinaria huronensis, including a really nice green grafted specimen here that I got from Jason Fox a couple years ago. I'm not doing the flattering lighting color thing right now. I just kind of wanted to give you like a rough draft of what's in here. There's a really beautiful, like, it's kind of like a spiny scroll coral, really neat. That was frag grown. I picked that up at Reefstock. But probably what I'm most proud of is my Duncan. I've had this Duncan coral, six or seven years from one single frag. And that colony is huge and it's dense. There's like two or three stories of polyps inside of it. So like I was saying with the 75 gallon tank, since I'm using the power heads in the back bottom corner, I've got a 4 to 6 inch strip in the back where the rock isn't. So these tanks are actually a lot deeper or wider from front to back than they appear. You can kind of tell there with the Duncan on a magnet. So I am going to be employing a lot more magnets on this tank because there's a whole 8 inch section there on the back with no coral. So what I want to do, put together some magnetic shelves, and I think I'm going to break that guy into 10 pieces. I could probably make 10 frags, 10 reasonably sized frags, and just make a giant wall of Duncan Opsamia there on the back. Very, very cool tank. I really enjoyed putting them together. It was kind of a rush, but the last 2 weeks, I've really just been enjoying them. Once again, I'm not taking the time to do the whole like filter and get the lighting just right. This is what the tanks look like from day to day. So we got the 100 gallon, got the 75 gallon, we got the 40 gallon. And I hope you guys really enjoyed this because the innovative marine row has come together really well. There's gonna be more growth, more development, but there's one more new tank that I haven't shown you guys, and that is the Waterbox Crystal Peninsula Aquarium. So this has my first big pet fish in there. I'm going to set up to shoot another video for you guys on this entire system. This is a standalone system, so the equipment I talk about in here will be a lot more applicable to you guys that want to learn. So if you want to see what this tank is all about, make sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell, and comment, and we'll be back at you with a video of this tank very, very soon. And in the meantime, if you haven't seen the other intro videos on those particular aquariums, make sure and go back and check them out because they're looking really, really cool, y'all. So yeah, thanks for tuning in. I'll catch you guys on the next episode.